And the next story is about the pride of Antrim, Carrickfergus Castle. Carrickfergus Castle's a very famous place, isn't it? Well then, tell me one thing. Why is it that you never read about my Uncle Alec and any of the books or articles that are written about it, eh? De Courcy's mentioned all right, and Essex. Sorley Boy MacDonald as well, that's all right. They deserve to be. But so does my Uncle Alec. And where's his name? I'll tell you where it is. It's nowhere. That's where it is. Well, I'm about to put the record straight, okay? My Uncle Alec was involved in World War I, but he didn't fancy the army one bit. He tended to go and get drunk instead of going on parade, and the army doesn't permit that, so things didn't go too hutsy-touchy for him. My Uncle Alec's father, who was a committed member of the Communist Party, told him to take his medicine like a man. Obey your orders, he said, and learn to shoot a rifle. You'll need it against the employing classes soon. So my Uncle Alec accepted his punishment, and mind you, it was no joke. Over in France, when you went out and got full drunk instead of going on parade, you were tied to a wheel. That's what happened to you, the wheel of a gun carriage. Imagine having a hangover tied to a wheel. It happened to my Uncle Alec about four times. The people who owned a vineyard should have given him a quad of gear for devotion to drinking. Anyway, in God's good time, they put him in the trenches. Some officer blows a whistle and he shouts, "Charge!" Up they go and over the top. 10 yards, my Uncle Alec runs, and then he goes down like 100 with a spuds. 3 holes in him. They took him to the field hospital, and then the base hospital. Then they sent him home for a fortnight's sick leave, and then they ordered him back to the trenches. "Don't aim at the Germans," his father advised him. "They're workers just like us. But if you see any employers of labour about," he said, "aim at them, all right." Well, the whole thing was academic. Into the trenches, officer blows a whistle, "Charge!" Climb the ladder, charge like anything. 15 yards, 100 with a spuds, 2 more holes in him. Field hospital, base hospital, 2 weeks sick leave. The fates conspired against him. The day before he was due to go back to join his regiment, he gets a treble up at the horses, £6. He got poleaxed for 2 more days as anybody would. The military police lifted him as he was sitting in the house getting dug into a pig's knee. He was charged the same day and got 21 days detention for whilst on active service being absent without leave. And now we're coming to the crux of the whole thing. For where did the army shove my Uncle Alec to do his 21 days? Right first time, Carrickfergus Castle, well-known British Army garrison, built in the 12th century, and crammed full of people like my Uncle Alec for most of the time ever since. He went into the dungeons every night. During the day, he got pack drill and running on the spot. He also had to whitewash the coal bunker till it looked like alabaster. Then the corporal threw all the coal back into it and complained because it was filthy. But one thing held him together during his ordeal. The thought of that shilling a day wages building up for him. With a pint at threepence, that made 84 pints. Good incentive for any prisoner. On the last day of his sentence, he's lined up with the others due for release. An officer sitting at the table calls out my Uncle Alec's name. "Sir," he shouts eagerly. "One and ninepence," the officer says in a bored voice. "Your head's cut," my Uncle Alec tells him. "It's 21 shillings. You are only entitled to 1 penny per day whilst in prison, my man," the officer says. "And that comes to 1 and 9 pence. Now pick up your pay and go." "Oh, so that's the way of it," my Uncle Alec said. "Well, if I was you, I would watch what I was doing." "Are you threatening me?" the officer says. "Two Irish, I'm threatening ye," my Uncle Alec shouted. And with that, he flattened the nearby sergeant, grabbed the table, upended the officer, money, papers, the lot. "How's that for a penny's worth?" my Uncle Alec shouted as it dragged him back to the dungeons for the rest of the war. So there you are. That's my Uncle Alec's story for you. He was a good one, wasn't he? I'll tell you this much. I reckon he was as good a man for the history books as that De Courcy or Essex or any of that lot. You never heard tell of any of them putting an officer on his backside, did you? Do you see these history books? It's not what you know, it's who you know.